You might have heard me mention this term ecological forestry. So what is ecological forestry? Basic idea is that forests are ecosystems, and while we may at times harvest resources from those ecosystems, we also need to manage them for biodiversity, ecological integrity, wildlife habitat, water quality, all of these other things that are part of how these ecosystems work. Now, this may seem like a really basic idea, but of course, for most of human history, we've been managing forests and other ecosystems solely as commodities. And when we do that, what we find is that it does a disservice to all of the thousands of species that live here, all of the critters that call this place home. It also doesn't manage forests well, because forests are these interrelated and interconnected communities of different organisms, and the way that they knit together and the way that they function is very complex. You can't just treat a forest like it's a cornfield and expect that community to be as vibrant, as beautiful, as resilient, as rich with life as it would be if you treated it like an ecosystem. We're also learning that treating forests solely as commodities does a disservice to ourselves, because we rely on forests very deeply. So what we foresters who practice ecological forestry, or as it's sometimes called, ecological forest management, ecological silviculture, is that we research the way that forests work naturally, and we look at old growth forests, and then we aspire to manage forests like they manage themselves. So rather than managing them just solely for the resources that we want to produce, we actually look at the natural processes that have governed the way that these systems work for thousands of years. And we use forest management as a tool to emulate those natural processes and even to restore them to forests. Within ecological forestry, there's also this idea of explicitly restoring old growth characteristics. How do we use forest management as a tool to make our young altered forests more like old growth forests centuries before they can do that on their own? And so some of the innovations that we might utilize would be stuff like leaving dead wood on the ground, creating gaps in the canopy, leaving some big trees forever, what we call legacy trees, and explicitly trying to create forests that are multi-generational, that are more like old growth forests. We also need to acknowledge the fact that we do and will always need resources to survive. And the question is, where are we going to get those? And so as practitioners of ecological forestry, we're trying to say, how do we get the wood, which is a local renewable resource, how do we get that from ecosystems in the way that is the kindest, the gentlest, that can even hopefully help these ecosystems heal and be healthier, more productive, more resilient in the future? I can't tell you that forest management or logging is categorically a good thing, but I can tell you that it can be done well. And the nuances of how we do it, how we choose which trees to cut, how we choose which forests to manage, how we navigate all of these subtleties and nuances of how we manage forests will dictate the value of the work that we do. I often say that ecological forestry is as different from timber-focused or industrial forestry as local organic agriculture is from industrial agriculture. So you would never go out to, you know, a giant cornfield where you might say, wow, this is really an intensive industrial way to produce food, and say, yeah, I think we just need no agriculture. You would ask yourself, how do we do this in a way that's better? How do we do it in a way that we get the things we need while also exercising a higher level of ecological responsibility? And in ecological forestry, that's what we try to do.